If I didn't care more than words can say.
Okay, I'm here in Lucas, Ohio now, which is about 15 miles outside of Mansfield. And this is the location that was used in the opening scene of the Shawshank Redemption. So this would have been where Andy's car would have been parked. His car would have been parked right out here where I'm standing. And you could see, it was here at night, so you could see both of these lights were on.
And what makes my head go round and round while...
And there was some light cast out front, and you can see the cabin straight ahead. So this is also the marker sign for the location as well. But Andy was sitting outside here. He was listening to the radio. He was drinking. He was loading his gun because his wife and the golf pro were up in that cabin. So he was sitting out here, and that's how the movie started. So they don't ever really show anything besides right here where I'm standing, but I'm gonna walk up here and show you the cabin. They do show his wife and the golf pro go inside, but I'm not certain if they actually shot that scene here at this location or if that was somewhere else, but you're led to believe it was here. So this is a really nice spot, and this is really like nestled back in the woods. There's a dirt road that takes you through the trees to get here. I'll show you around the backside. And
darling, if this isn't love, then why do I thrill so much? And what is it that makes my head go round
while my heart just stands still? Slightly, you can slightly see in through here. I've never been inside of this cabin before. I do know that when the door opens up to the cabin, it's like a wooden door with like a metal, I don't know what you call them, but it looks like almost like an arrow. So I would recognize that if I saw it. Okay, I'm in Upper Sandusky, Ohio. And this building in front of me is the courthouse that was used in one of the opening scenes of the Shawshank Redemption. This would have been the courthouse that was used when Andy was on trial for the murder of his wife. They filmed those scenes inside the courthouse, up on the third floor. They used the courtroom that's up on the third floor, and I'll show you this little placard, which is pretty cool. Basically, if you skip about halfway through, it talks about the scenes that were filmed in there. And it also talks about Lady Justice at the top. It contains a copy of the movie in a time capsule. So way up at the top, right up there. I thought that was kind of cool when I read that. I had no idea about it. But unfortunately, it is locked up. I'm not able to get inside, but this is a good view of it. And this is the courthouse used in Shawshank Redemption. This is actually the room that was used as the parole hearing room. So when you come up into the room, you can see it's obviously being painted right now, but the building would have been right here, or I'm sorry, the table would have been right there. And you can see those four windows, and one of the recognizable features is this window, this little window that's in the door right here. I'm standing outside of the entrance to the prison. So in one of the early scenes in the movie, you can see the prison bus would have been coming in. It was like a gray prison bus would have been coming along this road. And then it turns right along here and starts driving down this drive. So this angle they used was high and in the air. So it sort of zoomed in. I don't have a drone and they don't allow them here anyhow. But this kind of gives you the idea. So it would have been high up and it kind of swoops in with the one of the songs that's very recognizable with the movie would have been playing. So there's like this grass strip that separates the two drives for the entrance and exit, but it's actually a really beautiful building when you stop and think about it and look at it, like the architecture. Of course, it was a penitentiary, so the idea of the concept of why it was built isn't pleasant, but the actual structure itself, when you tour it, take a look around, especially this front, the facade. It's actually really, really pretty. But anyway, this is where that would have been filmed on the way in. So I'm shooting this through a fence, so it's sort of hard for me to show you what I want to, but this is the best I can do. There's some pavement directly in front of me, right there. That's like an old paved path, and that's the remains of the road that used to run up and alongside the penitentiary. So I'm going to show you what I mean. So here's the west wing of the penitentiary. There's the front of it, and this west wing has all the cells from the west cell block. So there's a road that runs right along here. Right along the tree way, the tree line, I should say. All right, so there's the remains of that. So in the movie, The Shawshank Redemption, when the prisoners are coming, the bus that Andy's on, that gray prison bus, it was driving down this road that I'm trying to show you. And then it continues on and it goes around the backside of this, of the west cell block. And there's a guard tower that's sort of like, if I could jump over top of the building and show you, it would be right on the other side. So the bus would go down there, it would turn, and that's where the gate is. Can't go back there. It's off limits because there is a correctional facility, a current correctional facility that's in operation that's on the back side of this, so you just can't go that way. You can't take videos, or you can't walk and see it. But this is the pathway that bus would have gone. So it would go right down there, and that's also where, like, when Red was being released, when Brooks being released, that gate is right there. It's also where they brought them in, as I said, with Andy, when they were saying the fresh fish, when the inmates were first arriving. This is the exact same location as what's depicted in that picture. You can still see the yellow line, and the picture I just showed you, you can see the windows here. There's two, and then a door, and then over here on this side, there's a window, and this is where the inmates would have come out. So they came out, and they were they all lined up. They were shackled and lined up right here. Where they met the warden, and Hadley was here. In the movie, there was a like a cage that was here. That's where they would have done like the de-lysing. They put like the powder on them, and then they were spraying them off, and then they put the powder on. But that would have been right here. Placard that shows you the prison, as I was talking about. So you had the corridor that was here, you know, they had the cells on either side, and they obviously went up. You had these walkways. This is another view of it from, this is up from a level looking down. So when I raise the camera up, you're gonna see it doesn't quite match up. So you have the corridor and you have the cells on this side, but over here you do not. You have these windows and clearly just a brick wall. So the reason for that is they didn't film those scenes right here on site. They filmed those scenes at a warehouse that was converted into, make it look like it was a prison in downtown Mansfield, which is just a few miles from here. So they actually didn't do those scenes here in the penitentiary. I'm not quite sure why. I don't know if they just wanted that look to have it like a mirror image of cells across from one another. I'm not really certain as to why. Open for the tour because there's clearly a display in here. This is the central part of the prison. There's a column here. There's another column here. There's the bars that are here, and there's a big open area. It's sort of hard to see, I think, because of the bars and the glass, so the depth perception is a little thrown off looking through my screen here. But there's a red wall that's on the other side. There's a big commons area that's here. This is where they used the scenes in the Shawshank Redemption of the cafeteria. But it's basically where the east and west cell blocks meet. So I'm standing right on the edge of the east cell block, and if you go through that doorway across that lobby area floor, there's another doorway right here that goes to the west cell block. So this area right in here is what they used for the cafeteria in Shawshank. So this is the shower. So they did film the shower scene right here, and I'll show you right where they shot the scene of Andy and Boggs. So in the scene, Andy's standing in here showering, and Boggs kind of comes up next to him and is asking him. I think he says, you know, something like, "Is anybody come at you yet, or got to you yet?" Something to that effect. But Andy would have been standing right here, and Boggs would have been here. So this is the exact location he shot that. Is there's this pillar, this wall behind them comes over, has this sort of like a pillar, and then it shoots back and then goes back down again. But they shot that angle from right here, and I feel like you can see a little bit of that window that might be visible too. But it's a large shower room. It runs all the way down here to the very end. All the shower heads are up here that run along this pipe. And from what I gather, during filming, they shot everything in here, as I said, but the plumbing, there wasn't any running water in here. So from what I understand, they had a local fire department come and help. Like, I don't know if they used the water or if they hooked it up to this line to get it to run. But from what I understand, the water was extremely cold, so they did everything in like one take because the water was so cold during that scene. But this is a large shower area. Of course, they had a lot of inmates in here, so only makes sense. But this is where they shot that scene with Annie and Boggs in the shower. This is actually the chapel for the prison, but actually was used as the movie theater, or the room that they were showing the movies in at the time. So when Andy comes in, Red and the guys are in here watching the movie, the screen would have been right up here. Being projected from behind, and these pews would have been kind of more lined up straight across. That's when Red was watching it, and Andy came in to ask him if he could get him the poster. So when I swing around, you'll see the backside of it. So the movie projector would have been here, and the guys would have been sitting, and these pews would have been across. So Andy would have come in along one of the aisles behind Red, and he was asking him if he could get him the poster. But you'll see these pillars when he's making his way in and out of the theater. You can kind of see some of these pillars are visible when he kind of walks the camera and it kind of follows him and pans, and you'll see a few of these pillars. This is obviously the warden's office. This is his desk, obviously where he was sitting, where he would have shot himself. The glass behind him would have blown out when he fired the gun. The safe in the wall. Sometimes they actually have a safe here. There's not one here currently. And then they have some clothing articles. This is his desk, and this would have been the view that you'd have sitting at it. See when Andy's coming to see if he had any mail, he comes walking in through here.
Okay, the steps that you see in this shot were the steps that Floyd came running down to let the guys know that Brooks had a shank to Hayward's neck in the library. So this was taken from a guard tower looking down into that courtyard on an old tour that I was on. I only have a picture, I don't have any video. But here, right here to the right, are those same steps. This is from inside the prison looking through a barred window into that same courtyard. But those were the steps that Floyd came running down to let the guys know what Brooks was doing to Hayward.
Okay, this is the intersection that Brooks was walking across when he almost got hit by the car. So Brooks would have been coming down this sidewalk. Up there is downtown Mansfield, Ohio. He would have been coming down the sidewalk. He started out right about here, and a car was coming in this direction and hit its brakes. I think it hit its horn too. But you can see this little archway right here, these little windows, these arches. And right there is where Brooks was standing when that scene was shot. Okay, I'm here in Mansfield, Ohio, and this building right here directly in front of me is the building that served as the halfway house. I think it was referred to as like the Brewer Motel or Brewer Hotel, but this is where Brooks, when he's released from prison, he gets put up in here, and then of course later Red when he's out. But it's right here in Mansfield. They only use the exterior. When Brooks first arrives here, they sort of like pan down. They sort of like start like up from the like a sky shot, and then they bring it down, and you kind of see like Brooks' head and his shoulders as he's walking towards the hotel. They only use it as the exterior. I will show you where the interior is. It's part of the filming locations for the movie, but it's just not inside this particular building. Okay, so this is the room that was used as the halfway house boarding room that Brooks stayed in and eventually read later in the movie. Now, in the movie, they show this boarding room in the Brewer Hotel, I think it was called. But this room is actually in the upper portion of the prison. The front part of the prison has like administrative offices. That's where the warden's office was. That's where the parole board meeting was with Red. This room is actually above that. So it's not really in the Brewer, but it is here in the penitentiary. So a little movie magic. This is what everybody probably remembers from the movie. Brooks was here, engraved right up there. So was Red. And then, unfortunately, this is where Brooks would have hung himself. From right there along that wood, here's a little life-size cardboard stand-up of Brooks. And here it says, Brooks's room, and it talks a little bit about what I just said about it being filmed here and not at the halfway house. When you look out the window here, you can see what I'm talking about. Right there is the wing. This is the east wing of the penitentiary, so that's all the cell blocks that would run along there. And if you come around right about there, where there's some people standing down there taking pictures, right about there is like the edge of the front of the building that I was referring to with the offices. But when I swing back around here, you'll see the rest of it.
Okay, here's a look inside the grocery store that was used as the foodway. It's been renovated since filming, but this gives you a little glimpse as to what it looks like inside there now.
So I'm here in Mansfield, and this is the bench that was used in the movie The Shawshank Redemption. This would have been the bench that Brooks was sitting on when he was waiting for Jake, or seeing if Jake would return. He was sitting out here, I think like right here on this left side, and they were showing him feeding the pigeons, and he was waiting, you know, just talking about Jake, basically how he was out of prison now, he was alone and didn't have anybody around, and how much he missed Jake. So they show him kind of throwing some like breadcrumbs and on the ground, and there's birds feeding here, but he's talking about how Jake's not here, but he hopes that he's still doing well. Okay, so this is the room that's outside of the warden's office. This is the staircase that you can see when Andy's coming to see if he had any mail. He comes walking in through here. And of course, this is the door that he closes. So the door's shut when he's playing the record. I'll push it over. So he closes it and he locks it like this, with this lock. So he locked the door, and that's when he started playing the record from right over here. So the record player would have been on the desk. If you remember, he had all the stuff that was sent to him, the books and the records and things of that nature. So he was sitting there playing the music.
Okay, so here's a look inside the wood shop that was used for filming when the guys were in the wood shop working and heard the music that Andy was playing come through the speakers. This wood shop is in Upper Sandusky, Ohio, and it looks exactly the way it did during filming. It's almost like a museum. I'll touch on more about this wood shop and some things inside of it at the very end of this video, but this is one of the locations that was used during the playing of that song by Andy.
But before he played the record, if you remember, the guard, I forget what his name said, he had to use the bathroom, had to pinch a loaf, as he said. This is what they use as the bathrooms. It's actually not a bathroom, but they had a door on there to make it look like it. And this is where he would have walked in, and of course Andy locked him in. That's when the warden came first, and he's knocking on the window right here. And he's saying, open the door, open it up. He's pounding the glass, and then of course he steps aside, and then Hadley takes his baton and breaks through this glass here. And reaches in, unlocks the door, and then comes in here. And then you hear the record kind of scratch, and then that's the end of that scene.
Here's a look at the library. These columns right in the middle of the floor are very recognizable. You can see those in a couple of scenes. The library actually expands, if you remember correctly. Andy started doing the tax forms for the guards, and he had Red and a couple guys helping him out. So they actually knocked down a wall and expanded the library. So they used some of these other rooms for that extra space in the filming for the movie.
This area right here in front of me, right in front of me here, would have been where the warden was having his speech about how his inmates were going to do work on projects as part of helping the community. And definitely visible in the scene is this little archway here with the speaker. But you can see this as well. This little wall was definitely visible in that scene. And right up here is his office. So that's the warden's office right up in that spot. Okay, so this is the solitary confinement portion of the prison. So that's obviously a picture of Andy. And I'm gonna go in here and show you. These cells wrap all the way around it's like a circle that you can walk all the way through. It's basically like in the bowels of the penitentiary. So this hallway goes all the way around and it wraps, and it's like a mirror image of what I'm showing you here on the other side. These are the solitary confinement ones. So, I mean, they just have these huge steel doors that, that thing's heavy. It won't even really budge just by kind of nudging it like that. But there's really not much in here. There's, you know, like a bed on the floor. I know the lighting's poor, but there's not much light coming in here. There's a toilet and a sink. When they close that door, all you really have for any kind of light, I guess, is this little glass window. I mean, it would be horrible. Here's a little more light that better shows you. Toilet, sink, bed. I'll step in here. I mean, it would be extremely depressing. So when that door closes, all you have is that little peephole. But I'm gonna show you the one that they used for Andy. Would have been right here. So there's the warden. Now, what they must have done in filming is, I know the lighting's poor, but there's a toilet right there, a sink, and a bed. That toilet was gone in the movie because Andy was laying on the floor. His head would have been right about there. that runs here. You can kind of see the pattern on it. That's definitely visible in the scene with Andy. And then it comes into the corner right here. So Andy would have been down, laying in the floor, straight back in here. The toilet would have been gone. He was laying there, the door would have opened, and the warden would have been standing here. He would have seen that. Now, look at the light behind the warden on the brick wall that's behind him. As I said, it is pretty dark down here. But when I turn around and show you this brick wall that the warden was standing behind, it had light, like natural light that was shining on it. It would have been coming from this. There's a glass block window. So that would have been allowing some of that natural light that was behind the warden when he was standing there looking in at Andy. But this is what they look like from the front when they're closed. And this is what they look like inside. And this is the one that they use. Okay, this would have been the hallway that Tommy was cleaning. I think he was like mopping the floor or something when the guard came to get him to say that the warden wanted to meet with him. So very recognizable pattern. You see that throughout the main portion of this administrative part of the prison. But when they walk down, you can see this like arched way, this arch, and you can see that window in that scene. Right here's the arch. So this is the way he would have taken him to go see the warden. Standing outside the prison, and I've always wondered exactly where Red and Andy would have been talking after Andy was let out of solitary confinement, and the spot was right here. Andy would have been sitting down on the ground with his back against the wall. He would have been sitting literally right here with his back against the wall, and you can see this little chunk that's taken out of the wall. It's sort of like almost kind of like a triangle of sorts, but this little piece right here, and there's a little nick that's in the wall right here, and Andy's shoe was right there. Another thing, one of the angles that they show, there's a block that's right there, sort of has like a, it projects outward just a tad, but it would have been visible in that scene. As well as when Red stands up, he's standing right against this wall right here. And you can see a couple different things in that scene. So Red would be standing right here. There's some black streaks that are coming off here. I assume it's some like rust from the windows up above, but there's brickwork right here too. If you look at this brick, like a long rectangular one, and there's a little square that's right above where he was standing, as well as this piece right here. But that was all visible in that shot. Okay, so this is another prop that was used. This is the tunnel from Andy's cell, so that's obviously the warden looking in through it when he threw the rock through the poster. And this is one end of it. And I'll go over and show you the other. And that's the other side. This whole encased display here is of the sewer pipe that Andy broke through and crawled through. So here's a picture from the movie of when he took that rock and busted a hole through it, and he peeked into the inside of it. This is the hole right here that he was looking through. And then they have this set up as like a, you know, the tube, the tunnel. So he would have crawled all the way down to through this tube, and they shot it at the other end of him doing that through that circular part. And if you look up right there in the top is the hole that he would have busted through to get down into the pipe. This right here is part of the prop that would have been the pipe that Annie crawled out into from tunneling under Shawshank after he, you know, was trying to escape. So this would have been that he slid through into that stream like this. Right here, this is part of that prop right here. So this would have been the tip that you see right here when he comes out into the water. It's a little loud where I'm filming this. I apologize, but can't do anything about that, obviously. But this stream right here in front of me, this nondescript looking stream, this is what Andy would have escaped out of in the movie The Shawshank Redemption. So if you were to follow this stream, and you got to envision, this is 25 years ago, so all of this growth since then wasn't there. The pipe, it would have came out of the hillside. And he would have crawled out of that pipe and dumped himself into this creek. So I'll step around here and show you. So if you follow that tree line, where this tree line runs, it runs right along the creek. That building out there is a correctional facility. It's not the one from the movie. It's one that's actually currently in use. The one that was used in the movie is right over these trees. So there's a field, I can't access it or else I would show you, but that's where the pipe would have been, somewhere right about in here, and he would have dumped himself out, and then of course he stands in the water, looks up in the rain, and everybody knows that part. Okay, so I came over here on the other side to show you. So the bridge for the cars is right there, and the stream is right in this tree line. So follow my finger, the tree line, and then right there's the penitentiary. That's the one that was used in The Shawshank Redemption. So I'll zoom in as best I can, straight ahead. So in the movie, Andy would have tunneled through that. So he would have been tunneling underneath this field right here, based off, you know, the movie. And then it would have brought him out from underneath that field through that pipe right into the creek where he would have dumped himself out. This is all grown in. And a lot of this land is marked and private property, and I can't mess around with it because there is a correctional facility that's currently being used that's over there right behind the prison. So I can't show you everything I want, but this gives you a general idea. So this would have been where Andy crawled through the pipe and ended up in the ditch. So this bank directly across the street from me right here is the bank that Andy goes into after he's escaped from prison, when he's dressed in the warden's clothes and goes and takes out the money and then drops off the information that gets put in the outgoing mail. But it's supposed to be Portland, Maine. It's Ashland, Ohio is actually where we are. So this is maybe, I don't know, 12-15 miles outside of Mansfield, which is where the majority of the movie was filmed. But I'm gonna walk across there and see if I can see anything, you know, through the glass. Obviously, I'm not gonna be able to walk through a bank and film, but we'll see if I can see anything over there. I'm across the street now, and you can see they have their sign here in their lower window over here. I'm gonna show you something. I can't go in. I'm gonna show you something really cool. I'm gonna press the phone up against the glass. Look straight to the back of the bank. You see there's a couch there, there's an opening behind it, a circular opening. That's the bank vault and the door. I'll zoom in. That's the bank vault and the door. So when Andy was talking to, I guess, the bank manager, when he was withdrawing the money and doing his transaction here, they were sitting like right in front of that. So right where that couch is, there's the opening, there's the vault. That the vault is open, and then to the right of that opening is the door. The door is swung open. But if you remember correctly, Andy, I think, was doing a transaction with the bank manager and maybe an assistant or something. There was a woman that was there helping. Anyway, that scene was shot right there, right straight back in Shawshank Redemption. So this is right outside of the front of the building. This is the facade. The warden's office is right up here. That's right where he would have been looking out the window when the authorities arrived. They all came pulling up here and parked their cars, so they walk up and confront Hadley. He was walking towards them there, and the warden was looking out of his offices, which is right up there. Side of the warden's office, right out here where this old fire truck was. This would have been where all the police cars were coming when they were coming from the warden and officer Hadley. You can see a bunch of police cars and people kind of congregated out front here. But this is the view that the warden would have looked at. Chairs right here. So he was turning around looking, and then I think he opened up his desk drawer here and got out some bullets.
Here's another view inside the foodway. It's obviously since been remodeled. First you see it when Brooks is working there, and then Red goes and works in the same grocery store. Check out this painting they have inside of Red on the wall. I thought that was really cool that they have this inside of the store.
Okay, so I'm back here in Mansfield. This is another movie location. You can see the sign right here, but this store in front of me would have been it's an antique store, as you can see, but would have been used as the pawn shop in the movie The Shawshank Redemption. So they show Red coming down the sidewalk. He's like walking in this direction, and he comes up to this window right here, and he looks in the window. You can see there's some chairs in there, but there was like a display case that had some pistols on it. He was talking about how he's having all these thoughts of ways to break his parole or something to that effect. But you can also see out the back window, when they show Red looking in through the window, you can see this little alleyway here on that building. That was like, they shot an angle of him standing on the sidewalk with this behind him. You can see these buildings right out that window. So this is the location that was used right here. And this is a location that was used when Red is riding in the back of that pickup truck. So they come over top of this hill, they come down the hill, and the driver stops the truck right here. Red gets out, and the driver takes sort of a right-hand turn and goes off in that direction, and Red starts his walk right here. So this is the road to Buxton. I love this spot. This is such a scenic, iconic spot in the movie. So he starts walking down the road. The road to Buxton sign would have been right about there. I'll zoom in a little. He continued walking down the road. You can see where it gets down in here. It dips down by that house and that outbuilding, and then it rises right back up the hillside by that tree that's way off in the distance. But this is the road to Buxton, and this is where you see Red walking in search of the oak tree. Okay, Okay, so this field directly out here in front of me is the field that Red would have been walking across. He was in search of the oak tree. He would have come down to this tree line right here, and you can see there's some woods. And right up ahead is a stream that he crosses over on a log, and he walks right up the hillside, and the oak tree would have stood right up there at the crest of that hill. Stream is right down there, crosses over a log, gets to the bottom, and goes up the hill. But this is the other side of it. So they show they were filming towards Red crossing, and this is the direction he came from. So here's something I found that was pretty cool. When Red crosses over this stream from the field that's behind me, he goes right up here and walks towards the oak, which should have been right up on that hillside. But look at this. This is pretty cool. There's actually a log that's still laying across, not still, but is laying across here. I'm sure this is not the same log, but there is one that's here, just almost in the exact location where Red would have walked. That's pretty crazy. It's like a big rock here beside it. There's the log, and that leads right over through this tree line, and then the field was there where the tree would have been. Pretty cool. This would have been the way that Red came in and around, and went right up the hill to the oak. Okay, I'm here in Ashland, Ohio, and this is another stop on the Shawshank Trail. And this building right here in front of me would have been the bus station. This is where Red would have gone to get his ticket to get on the bus when he started his journey to go try to find Andy. So you'll see these two windows here. Well, two sections of windows, I guess you'd say. There's a pair of windows here, and there's three or four of them over here. You can see those over Red's shoulder when they were filming that scene. So Red would have been inside here, straight ahead where those mattresses are stacked. He would have been standing right about there. So when you looked over his shoulder and out the window, you could actually see this street sign in the side of that building. can see the windows on top and bottom of it. You can see this portion of the building when he's standing inside here. This is the road that Red was riding on the bus along. So the bus would have gone right up this little hill. I'll zoom in. And you clearly see that barn and that house in that shot. So he goes right up that hill. On his way to, in search of Andy. But this is a really beautiful shot here as well. There's a lot of really good shots out here that you can find, and this being one of them. So this is the road that Red took to start his journey.
Okay, so the next thing I wanted to talk about was my most favorite scene and part of the Shawshank Redemption, and that was the oak tree scene where Red is in Buxton trying to find the oak tree. These are images of the actual tree when it stood intact before the storm hit. I took these images with permission back in early 2011, I believe. It was still springtime. There weren't any leaves on the tree yet. They were still buds. And I only had a flip phone with me. So that's all that was handy at the time for me. And I didn't have my digital camera. So I was on my way back from doing some kayaking and had stopped and was able to visit the location. And all I had on me was the flip phone. Fortunately, I took some pictures and a real grainy video. That's the best video that I had at the time because it's what the phone had on it. But I made a mental note that I was going to come back that summer and take some pictures and video of the tree with better equipment. However, that's when the storm hit and it split the tree in half. And from that point on, the land became really restricted as to who could go on and who could not. It was posted, and basically there was no trespassing, and several years after that, the whole tree came down. It's bittersweet to go back to this spot because the tree's not there. Now, I know some people look at that and think, so what, it's a tree. True, it was just a tree, but that said, it was almost like a character in the movie, and it was such an iconic scene in the movie. I was really fortunate to be able to go back and see it the time that I did, and it's definitely my favorite part in the movie. So this footage that I have is I know it's grainy, it's shaky. I was walking up the hill with an old flip phone, but I was able to salvage it. I actually thought I deleted this years ago, but I was going through some old files and came across it. So the pictures that I have here that are mixed in are pretty clear, and you can definitely see the remains of what was of the stone wall, and you can see the tree without leaves on it. There was just buds on it, as I said. But I bet you 2 months after this footage was taken is when this storm first broke the tree in half, so it was never the same after this point of the footage that you're seeing. So I hope any of you who are doing the Shawshank Trail stop at this location. Please respect the signs that are posted and the land that is here. I can assure you that the entire tree is gone. The stone wall is gone. As of the summer of 2019, the land has been turned into a cornfield, including the actual spot where the tree once stood. So the remains are completely gone. You are more than welcome to stop and see the site, alongside the road. The Shawshank Trail sign is still there. It's clearly marked. But as for, walking onto the land with hopes of seeing something, unfortunately, nothing remains and everything is gone. That said, all the other locations pretty much along the Shawshank Trail, you're more than welcome to visit, take a walk around, pictures and videos, do whatever you want from a visitation standpoint. They're really welcoming, and you're permitted to do a lot of things along the trail, along those lines. That goes for everything in Mansfield, Upper Sandusky, Ashland, Lucas, Butler. A lot of these places you can do all of those things. The Oak Tree Field is pretty much the lone exception.
All right, you can see the prison off in the background right over there. But right in front of me here, there's like a little podium. It used to have a placard on it, and you can see that there's like a fence that runs around this little section of stone with the posts holding up. It's like a chain. This area right here is where they used to have a section of the oak tree from the Shawshank Redemption, basically like on display. The reason I say on display is, I don't know what it was, 2011, 2012, somewhere in that time frame, a storm had fractured the tree. It basically split in half. So a large portion of it had broken off. It basically half the tree had fallen, and they actually brought it to this site and had it on display. So it was laying like right in through here. People could come and see it. And then the other half of the tree stood for probably 5 years before it also came down. So the tree is no longer, but for what I understand, they have since used some of the lumber to make things out of it. Be that as it may, this used to be the site for the portion of the tree, and it's no longer here. They do a lot of these movie site locations, signs, which is pretty cool. There's a thing called the Shawshank Trail, which you can follow. It's a map that shows all the locations they used. And this is kind of cool. They have a cardboard cutout of Brooks here. Let me see if I can get, there's a little bit of a glare off the glass, but there's Brooks. This would have been the doorway that he went into for the boarding house. This is also what I, from what I understand, what they use is, I think an office maybe inside of here for the newspaper in Portland that Andy sent the documents and the everything when he was at the bank. I believe he sent that to the, I can't remember what it's called, like the Portland Tribune or whatever the paper of Portland was. But this is the doorway to the halfway house. Okay, I'm here in Upper Sandusky, Ohio, and this building right here in front of me, you see the Shawshank Trail sign on it. This was the wood shop used in the movie The Shawshank Redemption. I'm gonna take you over and show you the sign that's right beside it. The sign over at the courthouse here in town where they filmed the scenes had one of these as well, these historical marker signs. So this one talks about this wood shop being in the movie as well. But this really is a wood shop. It really is a building. I'm gonna tell you, I had a really interesting twist to my movie location hunt today. This was the last stop on my Shawshank Trail list. I had never been to the Upper Sandusky sites, and I met the couple who owns this building, and two very, very, very nice people gave me a tour, let me walk through the wood shop. It looks like a movie set. I mean, it looks like it does in the movie, but they have memorabilia inside too. It was tremendous, and so generous with their time and giving me all kinds of information and telling me stories about the production, which is right up my alley. I love hearing that kind of stuff. But anyway, this was the icing on the cake. So this was my last stop, and I'm so glad that I came here in the order that I did. Otherwise, I probably would have missed out and not gotten a chance to meet them. But anyway, back to the building. I found it interesting that this building is red brick. The reason I say that is because if you remember in the movie, the prison was like a grayish stone. And there was like a courtyard out back of it. And then there were a bunch of smaller buildings that were, I don't want to call them outbuildings, but just, you know, like factory looking type buildings that were there during filming. Well, those have all been torn down, and there's actually now a real correctional facility in that location. But those buildings were this color. They were this red brick color. So I thought it was really interesting that this building, even though it's here in Upper Sandusky, it's not here, you know, it's not at Mansfield at the prison, matches the physical characteristics that you would have found in those other buildings. So, but what a really cool venue. I mean, I almost didn't come here because it was a little out of the way, and I'm so glad that I did now.
So here's a look inside the wood shop, and this saw right here on the floor has that very recognizable guard on it that you can see when Red is standing in front of it. Here's another angle of it here again. So when Andy started playing the music and all the inmates that were here in the wood shop were working and stopped, they looked up at this white box on the ceiling here with the X on it right there. The producers had all of the actors look up at that as though they were looking at the speaker when the music was playing. So that's why when Andy was playing the record, you can see all the guys in the wood shop look up at that mark. I'm gonna just show you a little pan through of what the other part of the shop looks like. There's that very recognizable saw again. As I said, that guard on it, that grated guard on there, is very noticeable when Red's standing by it during the filming inside here. And this piece of machinery right here is what they show Tommy taking like the big sheet of wood out of it when he's working in the mill. Here are some cardboard stand-up cutouts of the district attorney who was in the court with Andy. There's obviously Andy Dufresne. And there's a cardboard cutout of Boggs after he was roughed up. So this family also owns the prison bus that you see in the movie, but it actually was at a fair or a parade, I forget. So it wasn't actually on the grounds when I was there, but they own that as well. And over here on the far wall, it starts a huge collection of pictures and memorabilia and signed items, as well as some signed photographs. I mean, the family knows a lot of people who were in the movie and have maintained relationships and friendships with a number of them, as well as a lot of the people who are owners of either the property or buildings of the other Shawshank Trail stops. But this is all on display inside the wood shop, so definitely worth a stop in. And then lastly, here's a little thing for Brooks.
Here's another prop from the movie, this film reel said when he was being attacked by the sisters. Here's that scene right here. You can see some of the reels that are right here, and that's one of them.
Here's another prop. This was actually the door that was used on the solitary confinement part of the prison when Andy was inside. So this door is also in this little prop room at the prison.
Okay, this is a corridor. This is on the south side of the east block. This is one of the cells is open right here, so you can kind of see. You had the sink, a toilet, some shelves. The two beds, the bunk on top, but it's small. I mean, it's like maybe, 6x9. I'm just guessing. I mean, it's not large at all. Two people crammed in here like that, no way. When you come out, there's the doors for the cell, and when you come out, this is the concourse, or I should say, and this is all enclosed. There's obviously bars, and then down below is like the main concourse. Can't really see it that well that way, but this runs all the way down. There's six stories, and I'll back out and show you. So there's some people walking down there to give you an idea of how far and how long this this thing goes. So that's like the main concourse. All the cells are stacked on this side, six stories. I don't know what I'm on, maybe the third story right here. Okay, so I'm still here in Mansfield, and I'm at a location that I've never been to before. You can clearly see the sign here. It's one of the stops. This is the old foodway. This building used to be the old foodway where Brooks and Red both had jobs when they were staying in the halfway house. So you can clearly see it says KV Market now. It's been definitely modernized. It doesn't look like what you would expect to see from the old foodway.
Okay, so that's going to wrap up the video. I hope you enjoyed watching it. I had a blast making this video, having tracked down all these locations, again, doing the Shawshank Trail. I'm from Ohio, and many of these places are only about an hour and a half away from where I live. So I still get to see them every couple years when I make an effort to do the Shawshank Trail again. And it's just as exciting to see them the most recent time as it was the first, with the exception of the tree, because it's obviously gone. But it's a blast to do it. I highly recommend it for anybody who's thinking about doing it. It's definitely worth your time if you're a fan of the movie to take in these locations. I'm no expert, but I've been on it down the Shawshank Trail many times. So if there's something I can answer as far as a question you have about anything related to it, leave me a comment and I'll try to answer as soon as I can. I really can't believe it's been 25 years since this movie was released. It's crazy to me that it was 1994 when the movie was released, and it's already been that long. But it's still a movie that I own on. I have it on DVD. But if I flip it through channels and it's on, I still stop and watch it. It's just it's always something I've enjoyed watching, and I'm sure that's always going to be the case.